the line between winning and losing in this league is so fine. And, you know, we see teams like Georgia, they started off really dominant and strong, you know, lost a few. Now they're back. They've won, what, 5 in a row. But then we have the Bandits who fell to the Rock. And then we have the Rock who fell to the Nighthawks. So what do you think is going to happen? What plays out for the rest of the season in the East?
Well, clearly Georgia and Buffalo have separated themselves from the pack, right? And Swarm fans giving high five to all the Toronto Rock fans out there for defeating them and bringing them into a first place tie. And Georgia technically has the tiebreaker based off of division record. So if the Swarm win out, they will win the number one seed and the number one overall record in the league. And from that standpoint, they got a huge favor from Toronto. But when push comes to shove, I don't think it matters between Georgia and Buffalo. I think these two teams kind of will give you the representative from the East. I mean, no disrespect to New England and Toronto. They're good teams and they're scrappy teams and they're playing well. I just think Georgia and Buffalo have another gear that Toronto and New England haven't been able to get to this year. And it may come down to the final in the East being, you know, kind of the de facto NLL champion. Again, the Western teams, obviously, look, it's a league of parity. You can find any team that can beat any team on any other given day. But I just think Georgia and Buffalo really have staked the claim to the top two teams in the league at this point. And I think ultimately one of those two teams will walk away with the Champions Cup.